Welcome to the Andrea and Stacy show.
I'm Andrea.
And I'm Stacy. We're kind of discombobulated. A, the mic didn't want to work for some reason.
And we really didn't set this up.
Not at all. And then Allison may or may not be here, so we set a chair up in case she does come.
I don't know how she's going to get in it.
Well,
we'll move this and then she can walk
through. Yeah.
Okay, so hopefully you can hear us because... Yeah, I don't know.
We'll try it. Another notification.
Not gonna be pop-ups.
That's okay.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
That's right.
And we're here, so we're willing.
I have to show what Kimber picked out for me.
Okay.
If I can get it open. Stupid fingernails.
I'm getting my house ready for company, so... I'm exhausted.
Yeah. Kimber is Andrea's granddaughter.
Mm-hmm.
Has she been on here? One time a long, long time ago?
Maybe. I don't really remember. Well, Stacy always sends her cards for the holidays and different things. And we were looking at them, and we were going to pick Stacy out a card, but we found this little sells prints and posters, and so we got that instead. And we picked out a couple different ones, but this was her favorite.
Is it showing okay?
Yeah, you can see the little weirdo things in it. But it's called Cabin in the Woods or something like that.
I love it. Kimber and I see... faces.
Did they not send you a paper with a name on it?
That was it. Oh, there was. Nope. There was a name on the front, though, I think.
Ola Thynell is the artist, but Little Red Cabin. Maybe that's what it was called. Okay. I don't really remember.
This is perfect to come from Kimber because she and I see faces in everything we look at, and there are faces all in this.
Yeah.
And so it's like perfect.
They like see faces in tree bark and stuff like that. And
it's not dead people. It's just faces. I really like it. And the other one had like mushroom people, like kind of in an oval dancing. Yeah. That's what I'm going to say.
I think
doing.
How that lady makes that stuff is she takes stuff she likes and then she cuts out pictures from books and magazines and like literally just... glues them together and takes like pictures and stuff.
Oh, I see.
I don't know if she does any digital editing of them or maybe she does it all digital these days. I don't know. But I thought it was hilarious.
Get it back together. Ah, thank you.
I never get to mail anything in cool round things like that.
No, I have no reason to. I guess I could start writing letters and putting them in these and mail
that way. Everybody knows from you.
Yep. Who knows how much it would cost to mail something like that because it's a weird shape. Yeah, there's no cost on there. When a box, you know, probably be $2, this is probably $10.
Yeah. Just because it's special shaped.
Special. It's so special.
Oh, boy. Well, today's March 1st, so that's exciting. I was reading, and I was going to look it up because I was going to say something about March 1st. Beware the Ides of March. That's actually March 15th, but I'll see if I can find what I was going to say. Back it up with some.
There's still two in there.
Okay, the Roman calendar, March 1st is the new year.
Okay.
Now, a lot of people think we do the Roman calendar, but we're not. We're like the Greco or something like that. What calendar do we use? It's got a weird name.
I used to know the answer to that.
I'll look that up, too. You guys should look into calendars because, you know, dates are not what you think they are. There's nothing haphazard about anything. It's all...
Gregorian or something.
Oh, yeah. Georgian.
Uh-huh.
Gregorian.
Yeah. We'll get there.
Anyways, the why March was kind of the new year. It was like the Romans who conquered everything would take time off, you know, like in winter and stuff, like from war. But as soon as like the new year, they would celebrate March 1st, the new year, and then they would all get ready to go back to war. Only Romans, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why is that? What do you think, Allison?
She's still hung up on Gregorian.
Yeah.
Gregorian.
She's just Googling it to prove us wrong. I don't know what my hair is doing either. But so anyway, so the Chinese New Year was a while back. Like, mm-hmm. It comes in some February, January. I don't know. Wasn't it a while back? Maybe it was November. I don't know. Chinese New Year.
It was February 1st.
February 1st.
Well, it falls on that weekend because the 20...
Well, in the United States,
yeah.
It was February... is it February 12th?
12th, okay.
12th, okay.
Next year, it's February 1st.
Okay. It was February 12th in the United States. Now, they don't use our January, February, March, April.
Right.
You know, that is just the day they're celebrating New Year's happens to be our random February 12th date. But it's the year of the ox. Oxen. And then the Lunar New Year was not too long ago, right?
Yeah.
Let's see. Oh, the Lunar New Year is what the Chinese celebrate. So they celebrate the first new moon of the whatever. I don't know. I'm going to say... what day is it in China?
But and then Rosh Hashanah.
The date in China, it's Tuesday, March 2nd, 2021.
Yeah.
That's what it is in China today.
They're a day ahead.
Yeah.
Like a...
oh, that's just the time thing. But I'm just saying in China, they don't use January, February, no. March, April. Yeah.
We have New Year's Eve that we celebrate. There's Chinese Lunar New Year, Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Sinkurim, which is, I'm saying that wrong, but it's Thailand. And I don't know of any others. Indonesia has two New Year celebrations. Russian Orthodox churches observe New Year's according to the Julian calendar, which places the day on January 14th. Vietnam is usually in February. Iran celebrates New Year's Day on March 21st.
Okay. So the world has universally decided on the Gregorian calendar for the most part. So if you book a flight, you know, to anywhere in the world, airlines are going to recognize that it's March 1st, 2021. Yeah. But all their holidays, all celebrations from, like, Jewish is different than ours. They have different months. Chinese have different, you know, days, months, New Year's. It's... the world's not what we think it is, people. We've all grown up in a bubble.
Yeah.
Your eyes are itching again. Do you think it's the lights or is there something up here?
I don't know. I've thought about that after I've left. Because
the plants, when I brought all the plants in.
That's what I'm saying. I don't remember mm-hmm. doing it before. And they're not just itchy. They get like, feels like something's in it right there.
Ooh.
Like, you know, something's mm-hmm. there. And I know I'm not allergic to cats because I have cats.
I cleaned up here, but I will say the plants, you know, they're... there could be something in the soil.
I sneezed when I came up here too this time.
When I moved those clay pots, some of them had like that powdery mildew on it. I wonder if you're...
Maybe
it's the spores or something.
I don't know.
I'll bleach it all.
I'll be fine.
But it just didn't do it before. It's only been recently. Yeah. And I think it's been with the plants up here, honestly.
That's weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
because the plants have been up here before. It's not.
Yeah,
the...
but I don't usually get like mildew on the pots, so that right moisture heat mixture may have caused something to bloom out. And it's different plants.
They
are different.
Yeah,
you know,
brought more up this time.
I took a lot of them down. I'm trying to filter them back out. I've gotten to the, I'm tired of trying to make everything live, so. If it pulled through, you know, it's got its last go around, and we'll see what happens.
Take a little chocolate off my lips. Mm-mm. That, like, this minute it hit my lips, it melted, and then I bit it, and it, like, stuck. I was trying to cover it up. There's no telling. I can't tell if that's a shadow or chocolate. Okay.
I don't see anything on your lips.
Okay. Good. I got it all. Oh, goodness.
Anyway, it was... Yeah. March 1st. Yay.
Yay. I haven't done anything in about 6 weeks, I guess, on the weekend. I have just been chilling.
Mm-hmm. Good.
And it's been so nice.
Mm-hmm.
The ebb and flow of life, man. Of course, when we had the snow and stuff, I couldn't have done anything really with no water, but...
There's a time to stop.
There
you
is.
Know?
You just
it's
have
different
to.
For everybody.
Yeah.
We all hit that cycle. If you don't get your chance in your body, that chance to recover. Like, I've been, you know, battling illness up and down, like, the last few weeks. So, this weekend, I just slept as much as I could.
And we've, I don't know if I said it in the last podcast, but we've been so busy at work.
Oh, yeah.
That your mind is constantly running. And it's like a basket that's just not big enough to hold all the eggs. And so when you get home, you're just happy to be home.
You need the quiet. You need to clear your head. You need to...
Ooh, though. Okay. I don't think I've talked about this. But if I have, oh well, we'll repeat it. Has it been a year now that I haven't had my iPod case? Probably.
It's been a long time.
A long time. I lost my iPad case.
Definitely in the summer.
Or not iPad. AirPods. I have my AirPods, and I'm positive one of the kittens knocked it somewhere and played with it into another room.
Mm-hmm.
We've gone through all the couches, moved furniture, we've looked for it, can't find it, and just randomly at midnight on a Saturday night, I'll look for them again, can't find them. So Jeff had some skull candies that I've been using, and then I lost the right one. And the reason they're so important is because at work, I constantly have music or a podcast or something going in one ear. And as anybody knows that you know, you have music to clean the house, music while you're at work, mm-hmm. it just makes the day flow better for me. So the problem with the skull candy is if you lose the right one, the left one won't work. It doesn't sync individually like the Apple product does. So
they can't stand alone.
Yeah. So it's been like 3 or 4 weeks since I haven't had anything in my ear at work. And it's not that it's boring or dull. It's just that I need that constant noise.
Mm-hmm.
So Jeff bought me a pair of AirPods Saturday, and I used them today, and it was like heaven. I remember better when I have music go or any noise in my ear. I can zone it out to hear, you know, to talk to anybody or anything. It's not like that, but it was so nice to that again. I felt productive, and I didn't feel as tired, because I think when I have noise in my ear, if you tell me something, I'll remember it. If I don't and you tell me something, I constantly go over it in my head because there's nothing else going on up there. And then it just becomes all these thoughts rolling around of what I need to do next, what I'm supposed to remember for Friday, or, you know, whatever it is. So I feel my chi is back.
That's good. And I see it as like eliminating background noise.
Yes.
You're controlling that.
Yeah.
So what your frontal focus can be selective.
Yes.
You know, because there's no noise in the
background. I agree with that.
That's when I'm doing stuff, I can... Like, I can't play certain music and then, like, you know, write.
Right.
But when I'm doing tasks and trying to stay busy, I need something, you know. And it's, for me, sometimes it's music. Like you said, podcasts are good because I like the talking And then, you know, a TV show that I already know, like not something I'm trying to watch new.
Yeah.
So I think it's important.
I think it is, man. Mm-hmm. I don't know how I made it as long as I did without any.
Because if you think about it, in today's world, we're not working outside in nature to where that would be our background noise.
And
there are feeds coming. You'll hear conversations down the hall. Yes. You hear traffic. So that all can be distracting.
And I forget how loud those
trucks big, going down.
Well, the sewing machines.
Oh, the sewing machines.
They're incredibly loud. The long arms. And then, you know, they're sewing around me on a regular machine. And it's... You don't realize how loud it is after you've been in there for a while, but it's interrupted.
Yeah.
It's not a constant hum. It's an interrupted noise.
What I do not like about Chickasha's downtown.
Oh man.
Is there's no way to go through our town to go south without going really through right through downtown Main Street.
Yeah.
You know,
you'd have to go all the way to
semis,
one side and,
any big rigs hauling large loads. They all go down what's our 4th Street or Choctaw, you know, to get to make that connection to Highway 81 north or south.
Yeah.
And when you're downtown, you know, a semi, I mean, God bless them, if they have to stop at one of the red lights.
Yeah.
And then they have to get going in that reverberance of that like,
and
sound.
All of the
I can't stand it.
Emergency vehicles go through there because it, you know, if there's anything on that side of town. So
I cannot stand it.
It's if you yell downtown, it echoes because it's like a big city. It's just tall buildings. So the sound just is caught there.
I can't stand it.
But that's okay. I have my AirPods now or whatever they're called.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know what they're called.
AirPods?
AirPods?
iBuds?
I'm not good at that.
Cordless headphones.
The wireless ones that are white.
I still walk with my wire ones.
Yeah, if my phone would take it, I would. But I have to have converter.
Oh, yeah. I just want the opportunity to be attacked, and then I use my headphone cord as like a strangulation device.
Yes.
That's my plan.
Yeah. That would be great headline. Because, you know, Allison would be like, she had cords on her. Like, yeah. That was her weapon of choice.
Yeah. Look like a middle-aged woman. Just can't get with the times walking down the road.
Oh, my gosh.
Or heavily armed badass.
Yes.
Yeah.
The new jeans at Target. I saw an ad, and so I guess they're here in Oklahoma, too. But you remember the jeans that had the V in the front with the pleats, and it dropped down pretty low? That's what they sell.
Oh, yay.
Mm-hmm. And they're coming back to high-waisted, not bell-bottoms, but, you know, wider leg.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The flare jeans.
Those never looked good on anybody.
Flare.
Yeah.
Not boot cut.
No.
Flare.
Yeah. A flare.
Pleated. Ugh, really?
Yeah, they're so bad.
Maybe if you're like flat, a pleat is nice. But me, there's nothing on me flat.
Yeah, that's so true.
In my forehead.
My effect isn't even flat. I've been watching too many serial killer shows.
What
he has a flat effect. Been looking at people just so I can determine their effect.
Well, me in most social situations I find myself in, that's what I have. People randomly telling me things about them I didn't ask. I need to work on that.
You know, no, you don't. Because
last thing we'll want is me paying attention to what they're saying.
That's what I was thinking. Because you'll start categorizing, and then the next time you talk to him, you'll be like, "You liar! That is
not
what
you
said
last week."
Yeah.
Carol? No, not Carol. We know a Carol.
We know a Carol. Karen.
Irene.
Irene.
I don't know an Irene.
I don't either.
Oh, Lord help
I'm working on like putting out good vibes though.
Me
good
too.
Energy,
I worked on that today.
Controlling my thought pattern.
Yeah.
I'm working on it because you know I don't have the energy to be cranky anymore.
Oh.
I just need to strive for that willful naivety. Whatever that word is. Ignorance is bliss. is my new goal.
There is a movie.
If somebody comes and tells me, you know, they flew to the moon last weekend, I want to just be able to say, well, aren't you lucky?
Yeah. Hope you took your jacket.
Yeah.
Instead of it being an all-out war.
Yes. Like, aren't you special?
Special. Send me a postcard next time you go. Turner and I watched a movie. And it's on Netflix, and it's I Care a Lot. And the movie itself is fine. But what the female role, I don't want to give too much away, so I'm going to be very general here. What her profession is in the movie will make you angry because I'm positive it really happens in real life. But I don't want to say what it is because it just came out. So if anybody were to see this, I don't want to ruin it for them. I'll tell you later.
Okay.
But I was angry. I was yelling at Turner like, you know this really happens in real life. You know this does. And you would think that certain things were going to happen, and they did not. And it ended well, but the ending made me angry.
Mm.
And I can explain that.
It's a very angry
very, very angry. I haven't felt that much emotion at a movie in a decade, probably. Because, you know, I don't get scared of scary movies. Mm-mm. I don't get emotional with love stories or any sappy movies. So apparently the only thing I can tap into is rage when I watch a movie. And sometimes that comes out in, this is just a stupid movie. Why are we wasting our time? But, this one, I really hope what happens in this movie doesn't happen in real life. But you know it does.
I need to know what this is.
Yeah, I will have to tell you. But I won't give it away. If it was already been out for a year, I'd talk about it. But, oh, I hear someone.
Spoiler.
I'll just get up and she can... Allison, this way.
Yeah, I got
this. Oh, sorry. Did you go to the city today?
Yeah. I cut my bangs at 4 a.m.
Ah, they're cute.
They came out pretty even.
Yeah. We've been on for 23 minutes, I think. Yeah, they look really cute.
I like it.
Your hair's going back to brown.
You did a good job.
Thank you. Yeah, I've been growing it out in case I want to dye it or bleach it or anything professionally.
Professionally?
Yeah, because I don't want to
dye it. I wouldn't bleach it at home. Yeah.
I tried. Yeah. It wasn't good.
I was in the middle of a PUBG game and she came in crying and
I burnt my skin.
Yeah, she burnt her scalp.
It was blistered.
Yeah, it was bad. Gosh. And I vaguely remembered her saying she was going to bleach it, but in my mind, I thought it was like a kit of like a lightener with a dye. I didn't realize she had bought actual bleach, and I had to, it was bad. It was breaking, and...
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah.
Scary.
In retrospect, I didn't feel regret about who I interrupted your game with.
Yeah.
Me
neither.
Are you saying you were not... Sorry.
No. And you know they're watching it. Kiss my booty.
I was gonna say bleached booty. Like, no, not that.
Mm-hmm. You still said it though.
Yeah, it's funny. That makes me think of Bridesmaids. Like, the show where they were like, I won't say it. We'll keep it G-rated. But.
Have you seen Bridesmaids?
Yeah, I had to watch it for a college class, actually.
Oh, okay. That's
great. Probably should slide this
up. Oh, yeah, we don't know if we're actually being recorded.
Yeah.
So we've been leaning up to the mic.
It wouldn't work when we first started, so I don't know.
The hacker. Weird.
The hacker.
Hack attack.
Hacky sack.
You know what else I've noticed coming back? The geometrical prints and, like, the slightly wrong, like, peach and aqua colors.
Yes.
Ew.
You know what I'm talking
like
about?
I've seen that in the fabric that's
2012.
Yeah. I've seen that in the fabrics that are going to be for next
year. Or
1984.
Yeah. Whichever.
Yeah.
Like tribal patterns was popular in 84.
No, tribal patterns were popular in 90.
Yeah.
But ew. Why did you guys let it happen at all?
It's happened
three
again.
Times now? Three times in your lifetime?
Now, this thing, the Saved by the Bell, the original ones, they had it all, you know, like through there.
Oh, like the picture I drew for Patrick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's not terrible.
Yeah. Well, it's not good enough to want to have to wear it again.
Mm-mm.
But I mean, we're
so nothing new.
Style
so
conscious.
Is.
I think
I am. It's just hidden.
It's hidden where?
I bet you I can get some of my grandma's like those plastic earrings.
Oh
and
yeah.
Stuff. We can start wearing a pair of those
that
like every
fun.
Week.
You just put them in a bucket and pull them out.
Mom was the first to pierce her ears.
Nice. Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
And now we're pierced.
Yeah, I moved out and pierced in 5, 2, 2, and 1.
My great grandma's, their earrings, rhinestones and pearls,
what?
That big.
That's crazy.
Yeah. No clip ons for him.
I couldn't do clip ons.
They hurt.
They had to have been like tightened down.
Yeah,
because
the little screw
heavy.
In the back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because they were real.
Uh-huh.
And they were Bakelite if they were plastic. They weren't lightweight, like cheap plastic we have now.
Grandma Peggy had clip-ons, right?
Mm,
I think she had both.
I think she had both.
Because I had a collection of her clip-ons.
Yeah.
I played with them when I was little.
Didn't it hurt?
Yeah, but it squeezed. Yes.
And then I'd hit it with the phone or get it hung in my hair, and I just was like, I can't do it.
No.
The woes of clip-ons. You know where I did wear them, though? On my shoes.
Hey, that's a cool idea.
My dress shoes, I'd clip them on the top and the center. And I got the idea because they started selling these. They had, like, metal teeth, and you'd put them on for, like, weddings. You could get them. And I was like, screw that. They were however much they were. Who knows?
Mm-hmm.
And I could have those earrings on my shoes. Nice. They were cool.
Nice.
I even put them on my – I had one pair of kids, and I'd clip them in the shoelaces. So it would have, like, a – flat disc of color or whatever.
Cool.
But
I remember button covers.
Oh my god,
those were like a late 80s thing.
Have you seen a button cover?
No idea.
You have a button and then you have a cover. No, it was a metal deal, at least the ones I had, and they were like, you could get them in brass, gold, or silver, and then they would have either rhinestones on them or they'd be fabric covered, and some you could decorate yourself, and it had an opening that was just a tiny bit smaller than your button, and you would push it till it went on.
Oh.
And then it would be a cover, and you could change them
fancy.
Out.
That's cool.
For different outfits or blazers or whatever.
Yeah.
I may have a package of not decorated button covers at home.
They had the ones, like you said, that pushed on. You know, they would kind of expand to your button size. And then I had the ones where you would flip it open, and it was just like a fork thing.
Oh, yes.
And then you would snap it closed.
I forgot like about those.
Kind of go around the thread of it.
Yeah.
I had the rhinestones ones. I had a silk long sleeve button down shirt that was in what would now be called the tunic style. And
that was just menswear, right?
It was considered an oversized men's shirt.
Yeah.
Because I also had a tie that went with it, I'm not going to lie. But I would sometimes wear my button covers, and they were like the amber, like turquoise, like rhinestone, real fake looking.
Yeah.
It was nice.
I had several silk shirts. And then I discovered after I bought like six because I liked how they look that they were very hot. Mine, I got hot in mine. And you really needed to wear like a camisole under them or something so they would lay smooth. Mm-hmm. Mine were oversized, but not the big men's shirt. They were just like longer and wider. So they still fit really up here. They just kind of went down. But I think I have pictures of me in one of them.
I wore that purple shirt with my way too tight jeans and my suede leather ankle height scrunch boots.
I can see it.
Yes. Yeah.
I want those boots back.
Yeah, I love my scrunch boots. And I also had a skirt.
White ones always made me uncomfortable.
What?
The white ones always made me uncomfortable.
Yeah, who could keep those clean? Mm-mm. That was a problem. I had a skirt that I absolutely loved, and the first top part of it was, you know, tight, and then it had three ruffles that came out, and it hit me right at the knees. And so you'd be really cinched up, and you'd tuck your shirt in and then pull it out just a little bit all the way around, and you would be, you know, like T-shirt, rolled up sleeves, and cinched in like this far from the skirt and then ruffles. Mm-hmm. And if you wanted, there were vests that you could wear with that outfit.
Mm-hmm. And if you're and modest, you had the biker shorts underneath white biker shorts.
Yeah, and you wear Keds with scrunch socks and two different colors to match your skirt and your T-shirt.
Go check out the line of Keds today. They're awesome.
Are they?
Yeah, they are.
I haven't had Keds
in forever. I bought Kimber a pair last year just because I was like, oh, Keds. And I think I'm going to get a pair.
Might as well.
Yeah.
I only wear Vans, so I might as well get me some Keds. They're not much different. I just wear Vans because I know what size and I don't care what they look like because I just wear T-shirts to work. See the face and the eye roll there.
I didn't roll my eyes.
It looked like it.
And I just looked up.
Okay.
You know, and every fashion trend we did had already been done.
Yes.
And every fashion trend today has already been done.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Nothing new.
No. As long as we don't go back to powdered wigs and colonial
capes.
Area.
You would wear capes. She did see a cape and those last weekend or whatever.
Yeah, Goodwill. And like big poofy dresses, and I would wear those again.
Man, I hated those poofy sleeves and those dresses that had the fitted V waist and then the poofy sleeves. Oh,
I'm gonna tell you, everyone had pit stains.
Yeah,
when those dresses were a thing.
Yeah, and there was like tulle in the poof to keep it poofed, and it never failed. There'd be one little piece that would poke your shoulder all day. And we had shoulder pads.
Yeah.
We went through those shoulder pads. Like all the sweaters came with shoulder pads.
Yeah.
I had a sweater that I absolutely loved, and it had like pearls, but they weren't white, like all over it. And it was the most uncomfortable sweater, but I loved it. It looked so cool. And then I had a sweater. This is my when huaraches were cool.
Huaraches.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was one that the sleeve hit here, like it wasn't 3/4, I don't know what that length is. Mm-hmm. It was longer than a T-shirt, but shorter than your elbow. And it was like wide, so when you held it out, it was just like that. And it had the pink and it wasn't teal, but it was that blue, and then the white that like went across.
Very
and it
nice.
Was knitted, and it was heavy, and I absolutely loved that sweater. And you'd wear it with stonewashed jeans, and I had jeans that have the zipper in the back with the bow at the top.
Zipperless.
I'd
jeans.
Wear those today if I found some. There was a zipper about this long in the back right here, and it had a denim bow at the top of it.
The way my legs swell when I take them off, you'd be able to see the zipper.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Yeah.
Middle-aged problems.
Yeah.
was funny, though. When I was younger, I didn't mind tight-fitting things.
No.
Now I can't stand it.
Yeah.
Like, anything that I have that looks tight is stretchy. Like, you know, it's, like, stretchy fabric.
Yeah.
So it takes the shape, but it's not. The fabrics we wore didn't stretch.
No.
There was no...
It either fit or it didn't.
Acrylic blend, spandex, like, blend materials.
If you threw yourself on your bed and couldn't zip up your pants, you had to just peel them off because
mm-hmm.
there was no... your only hope is if you stand up, couldn't zip up your pants, you'd lay down and try.
Stretch
and if
out,
that
yeah.
didn't work, then
yeah.
they had to go till next week or whatever when you lost 2 more pounds.
Mm-hmm. But it was easier to
that's
maintain
the deal.
Weight.
You had, yeah, you had pants mm-hmm. that you wear this week or that week because nothing stretched.
No, mm-hmm. it didn't.
So I always had different sizes of pants mm-hmm. for that. But you were very aware. If you gained 0.5 pound, you knew it
mm-hmm.
because nothing
your
stretched.
Your clothes didn't feel
yeah.
good.
Yeah.
You didn't want to eat anything because you couldn't breathe.
You know, those, I have some buttons downs that, huh? I have some button downs that are stretchy,
mm-hmm.
you know, but back in the day, they didn't move. I mean, they
mm-mm.
they would be on your arm, tied up and stuff, and
yeah.
so you would have to lose
I don't
weight.
Like that. I have hoodies that are my like they fit, and sometimes they're too tight, and I just like panic. So I have to wear it oversized, even if it's my size and it fits. It's just like
feels
just
like
that
it's
much.
Suffocating.
Yeah,
yeah,
and it's like one night I may not be able to handle it, but the next day I can hang out.
Yeah.
In.
Mm-hmm. Imagine your whole wardrobe
I couldn't
being like
do
that.
That.
I'm like that, too. Like, I'll put on an outfit that I've worn 100 times, but that day it feels
yeah,
weird on
yeah.
me, and I can't
yeah.
stand it. So I'll, like, usually end up in, like, putting my pajamas back on
yeah.
or something because I can't stand the texture.
Mm-hmm. And I'm trying to – I bought Dickie turtlenecks
uh-huh.
because it's too hot sometimes. In Oklahoma, it's too hot to wear, like, a full-on long sleeve and then, like, a sweatshirt.
All right, Wallowitz.
Yeah.
Well, I'm trying to, because I can't, it's, like, on my neck.
Yeah.
And it's, like, feels weird. I feel like I'm suffocating, so I'm trying
have
to
have you ever just
that.
Seen people wearing chokers and want to go cut
yes.
it off?
Yes.
Not because they're having a problem
yeah.
with it, because I'm having
yeah.
a problem
you remember
problem
those
with
plastic
it.
Ones you would pull, like, over
oh,
your head
yeah.
and then they would go and just be tight on your
mm-hmm.
neck? And I'm like, how did anybody ever wear a choker? I tried, and I couldn't do it.
I can't. I have a strong gag reflex.
Yeah, there's no way.
If I swallowed wrong, it... I did wear the cameo with the little...
Yeah.
I'm telling you, all the clothes that I rarely had money for a new outfit that I could just buy, but when I would buy one, it'd be, gosh, it'd be like I didn't blend in with those around me. It was whatever I thought was cool.
Yeah.
Apparently, my taste is not like others. But I had this one where I was wearing, like, the straight leg black pants. And
yeah.
then I had an oversized white shirt. And I had a cameo thing. It was probably,
ooh.
Like, you know what librarians wore, to be honest. But I would happen to be, like, a sophomore. And I was cool with
I'm
that.
I'm channeling Pulp Fiction with that. That sounds cool.
I did always, like, our library had, like, magazines from different places. And I always really favored the French.
Yes.
Like... They were just better.
And they just had a better color palette.
Mm-hmm.
I've watched some videos on TikTok where somebody just films people walking in the
and
street from their apartment.
Up.
And the men will have on, like, canary yellow slacks. And when they walk, they just... they're fitted
and
to
they
them.
Look so good.
And then they'll have on, like, a watermelon pink shirt with it.
Mm-hmm.
And
tucked
I'm like,
in.
Oh!
Yes. I think I saw mm-hmm. the same video.
Did you? It
and
was
it's
fantastic.
Like, I've seen people, like, Americans that live there for school or they live there for a couple years. And they're like, you don't leave your house in leggings or sweats. You're dressed up
yeah.
every time you leave your house. And I can't do that.
You could there, though.
I
mean,
could. Like, if I had the motivation to do it, but it's hard to dress up
I found
all
it easier
time.
When I was volunteering for that paper.
Yeah.
I found it much easier to get up and get myself dressed and go out the door.
Sure.
But to go to Walmart, I couldn't pull it off.
Yeah,
no,
just to get up and
just,
go to Walmart.
Yeah.
No.
Since I don't have to leave for class or anything, it's been really hard
yeah.
to, like, get up and get dressed.
Yeah.
And brush my teeth in the morning, brush my hair. Like, I can go days without brushing my hair. And, like, I tried on, mm-hmm. 3 pairs of pants, and they don't fit. Because I haven't been wearing jeans, and
yeah.
I just didn't know that they don't fit anymore.
Somebody needs to go through my closet and pull things out, because, you know, I have a friend that gives me a lot of things.
Yes. Yes.
I promise I clean my drawers out constantly, and then they fill right back up.
I have piles of clothes and books, and just like go to Goodwill and buy everything, and it's bad. I don't have any room for anything.
I was thinking about our last week. We were also talking about fashion.
Yeah.
She was talking about OU shirts, and I was talking about striped workout pants.
Ew. I don't like stripes.
Neither do we.
Mom wants to get me an OU shirt when I move because she wants me to make friends with people from Oklahoma when I move out of Oklahoma.
Well, it's such a conversation starter.
Yeah, because I know so much about
OU. No, you don't have to. You don't have to.
And Dad was like, I probably have some that someone gave to me. Okay, thank you.
But I think she should, like, on the weekends throw on an OU shirt when she runs to the store.
Yeah.
Because somebody will be like, you know.
You a Sooners fan?
Yeah.
No, but my dad is. So, well, I mean, you could be too.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, and if I told her, if you hear someone from across the way yell Sooner.
Boomer?
If they yell
Boomer. Why would
Boomer,
they yell Sooner?
Yeah, if they hear Boomer.
Sooner Boomer.
Yell Sooner. I'm setting up for failure. I'm just kidding. Just yell it back.
Yeah.
Don't even turn your head.
Nah, I'm good. Anyway.
Allison be looking for the old people. Somebody yelled Boomer out.
Probably.
Maddie's group, they had, you know, they were supposed to, when they go out on outings and stuff, like, they had jackets that told where they were from. And I was like, that was high risk.
Yeah.
USA jacket.
Yeah.
Yeah, we didn't.
That's gotta make you a target somewhere.
I mean, in Spain, they could tell that we were not from there, but I'm glad we didn't have USAO stuff.
No, they couldn't.
Yes, they. When me and my friends went out by ourselves, what was worse was when we were with 6 old people and 4 just random teenagers, and we're like, we made our tour guide. We're like, we want to try that coffee drink. Will you order it for us, please? And we're like hiding behind her because we couldn't speak Spanish. It was so bad. We walked into a bookstore that was really cool, and she just said something to us in Spanish. We're like, okay. She's like, no, we're closed. In
English.
And that's part of my like cringe nightmares. Like, I lay in bed awake, like, thinking about that. It was so awkward because I made all of my friends follow me in there, and then we had no idea what was being said. Oh. Anyway, Spain was fun.
But I'd have been. I don't want to dream about it.
That was funny. Well, what was funny is, though, like, there were a lot of people there at restaurants, are like, waiters and stuff, spoke English, and they're like, where are you from? And 3 of us were from Oklahoma, and 1 girl was from Texas, and we'd say that. And he was like, they were all like, oh, well, I have family in Texas. I've heard of Oklahoma. It was actually really cool, because no one ever talks about Oklahoma or Texas. Yeah, they had, like, cousins.
Well, nobody in the United States does.
Well, yeah, that's what I mean.
For sure.
There's probably third graders in other countries that can list all 50 states.
Absolutely. I can't list all 50 states.
I used to could, but I don't think
we
I
learned
could
it
anymore.
In like third grade.
I think I could do the continents. I could. I know it's Canada, United States, Mexico, but I couldn't exactly draw the line.
Yes. So those are some of my favorite videos when they have people draw the states. In the United States. Oh, man, I laugh so hard. Because
Disney World.
Not that I could do better.
No.
But that it's, I know that's not right, but I'm not sure where to fix it.
I would have, like, the main ones, right?
Yeah, they
California.
Always start. They do New York, Florida, California.
Oregon, Washington.
Yeah.
And then I could probably go from the Dakotas to Texas.
And it would start bad with Texas because they didn't know the shape. So when they were drawing that in, it just kind of, and then Oklahoma doesn't fit in that, even if you knew what it looked like. Sometimes, I mean, if Oklahoma made the map, it was a blob somewhere randomly off to the left.
Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, California.
I could do the Florida, Georgia, you know, then Alabama, Louisiana, Tennessee. I could get maybe those, Arkansas, Missouri. And then I could probably guess
West,
like Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina,
West Virginia,
and then the West Virginia, DC, Virginia, Pennsylvania and be over that way. I don't know.
It's all those little ones around. It's
the potato states.
Yeah. I would just have to write East Coast. Who cares?
No. Yeah.
I didn't know New York was as big as it was until a couple years ago.
I have no doubt.
Because I don't care. Doesn't what? Matter.
It's a state? Yeah. I thought it was just a city.
Damn. Yeah.
Goodness. I don't think I have anything else to talk about.
No, we rambled on pretty good.
Yeah, I just hope it recorded.
It probably did.
Okay. Fingers crossed. We'll see you guys later.